What you doing, Curtis?
It's Monday.
And what's our Smorgasborg today?
We got an exciting day because we got the PS5 in.
First off, we gotta look at the label. Where'd it come from?
Oh, well, Purelayer brought it.
Let's crack this thing open.
Oh, we can't get the box and you in the same shot.
That's all right.
Sneak peek.
Alrighty. Let's see the damage of this thing after days of staying awake.
Bump, bump, bump. PS5.
It's massive. I didn't even get it out of the box. Guess we just rip ourselves open up a little.
Well, that will you.
One of these corners. There we go. This is the bad boy, though.
PS5.
This is the precious.
Sony, what's this say? 8K, 4K, HDR. Fine print.
Now it's time to the exciting stuff.
Wait. Are you prepared?
Yes.
Are you sure?
I am positive.
You've been gaming your whole life for this. Are you ready?
It's not like we don't have enough systems, as it.
Are you ready, kids?
Wake up, Mom and Dad. So it looks like it pulls out nicely out of its nice box.
Once again, slim fit in the box.
And then we get this white box. And then it opens up from the side. And we get access to another compartment. Eat it out. Oh yeah, looks like we got box number uno, and then this is the mega bitch itself.
Holy cow, gang, this is a big boy.
Let's open up this box first. We got instruction manual, looking real nice. We'll address that when needed.
Never.
Safety guidelines, don't need those. A nice high quality 8K HDMI cord, only the finest on the market. Power cord, pretty much a staple.
For supercharging.
I'm going, that's a controller charging cord. All really nice big ends on there. See that? Nice thick brick. Good job, PlayStation.
That shit's durable.
Look at this beauty. Get that out of its nice little box there. Now that.
Is that clear buttons I see?
That is a very futuristic next-gen looking controller, if I have to say so myself.
Quick question. Is that what aliens play PS5s with?
I'm pretty sure. Because at this point, this thing looks absolutely minty fresh.
Where's the home button?
It's literally the shape of a PlayStation emblem. Oh, it's already glowing. We haven't even connected it yet. It knows.
It knows. The motherboard's firing up as we speak.
Can say already from feel, buttons are crisp. It's got a nice matte finish on the white. So it's not like the classic PlayStation where it's really smooth and silky. It's got some nice texture to it. Gordon Ramsay would call this a fucking spectacular piece of meat.
Would salt bay sprinkle some salt on that thing?
Just like that.
Is that how
salt
he would do it?
All over the controller. We'll put that over there for now. And I think this is the mounting tray if you want it sideways.
You're going to put that big bastard sideways?
Holy hell. It's a rotating. Oh, it spins in case you want it sideways or up and right. So this is the mounting tray. Our mounting stand and then the tank itself. Holy hell. The system we've been waiting for, and unlike others, we ain't scalping this. This thing's going to good use. Nicely wrapped in bubble wrap. And then there's the infant, the baby Jesus's fetus itself. Kachowza. Look at that. Look at that nice tilt done by Matthew.
Stars from the bottom now.
Has a very fantastic look to it. The panels are fantastic quality. Very nice indeed. So we gotta get this thing mounted first, which if I remember correctly, it says something about the screw in the bottom.
Oh, look at that cooling for optimum games.
Oh,
you can game for 14 hours a day and not overheat this bad boy.
And a nice PlayStation emblem engraved into the panel on the right there.
What's the back got to offer? We haven't seen that thing yet.
The back we're looking at.
I think that needs another nice Matthew McGeary pan, doesn't it?
Yup.
Beautiful.
So you keep your, there's a nice little holder for the screw cap in case you just want to have it propped on its side. Otherwise, they give you a nice little screw there for attaching your system up right into the base.
In other words, you don't have to ghetto stand it up like the Xbox. See, Xbox, all tilty and whatnot. Not sturdy, not screwed down. PlayStation 5, screwed down much better.
There we go. Now we can go and pump it where it needs to go. As you guys can see, in comparison to the Xbox One, it's a little bit thicker and a few inches taller.
Then you gotta turn it on first.
And then we'll find the power button on this beast.
It doesn't have a power button.
Ooh,
look at that, people. Look at that.
All nice blue light pulsing. It's pulsing. All right, I can mess with that. I can yuck with that. Ooh, it's telling us to plug the controller in and then hit the PlayStation button. Very nice. What do you think, Matthew?
Looks pretty good to me. Does anything light up on the computer controller?
We got a nice light right above the thing there.
Yes, excellent, excellent.
Which is pretty tasty.
Mm-hmm. And now the PlayStation's lit up white.
Continue.
This could take 15 hours.
The PS5 system software will be updated. Yes, please. Yes, chef.
Well, only 7 minutes, not bad. Show us how excited you are to get your PS5. In dance.
Oh, he's cutting it up.
Oh, God. Your PS5. We gotta pause it for the lady that's gonna talk to us. If disc is inserted, don't inject it. Bro, that's assuming we've got money for a game.
Ooh.
It'd been cooler if they put 5 in V format, Roman numerals.
So that concludes the PS5 unboxing for the Smorgasborg this week. We're gonna fiddle around with it, and there'll be some videos up later in the week as we test out some of the new PS5 games as well as the playroom, whatever the hell that has. But yeah, thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week on the Smorgasbord.
And what should they do with the subscribe button?
Smash it.
Like, how hard?
Smash that subscribe button.